So let's answer some questions related to it to see how much we remember. So we've been running around for a while now. So from where do we derive the energy for it? Is it ATP? Is it phosphocreatine? Is it lactic acid? Or is it phosphoenol pyruvate? So the answer to it is ATP. So what about phosphocreatine, lactic acid, phosphoenol pyruvate? All these are high energy compounds, which we'll see later. So when we run around, what happens? We sweat. That is to maintain the body temperature. We even saw some medication related to it, which will help us keep warm. So these medications target which system to affect sweating? Does it target parasympathetic nervous system or sympathetic nervous system or sodium potassium ATPase or insulin? So sweating is a function of sympathetic nervous system. So there are so many muscles in the body. Those who go to the gym will know biceps and triceps. And we saw something about temporalis and masseter. So which is the strongest muscle in the human body? It is the masseter. So energy production, there is a lot of metabolic process involved we spoke about. So which is the odd man out, which doesn't fit in? Is it aerobic glycolysis? Is it anaerobic glycolysis? Is it gluconeogenesis or citric acid cycle? It is the gluconeogenesis, where energy production is stopped and it is reversed to reform glucose. So cholinergic nervous system, we saw that it affects lung function, it affects heart function, it also is involved in relieving ourselves, and it is also involved in muscle activity in a way that, you know, the muscle movements remain fluid when there is cholinergic stimulation. So what is the odd man out over here? It is bronchodilation, because it is a function of adrenergic nervous system. And in cholinergic stimulation, what happens is, it's like asthma patient, we have bronchoconstriction. So that is for this part of the video. So I will continue in my next video.